Yeah, when the government in Austria decided that there was quarantine and no one should leave the house anymore, it was a big change and it was difficult at first. You're used to climbing in a huge climbing gym. You had a lot of big goals for the season and everything changed really fast. But I knew there were bigger problems in the world than having a cancelled comp or a postponed comp. Our federation reacted quite quickly and implemented some YouTube live streams for all the national team members.
Für das nächste Training, ich habe das letzte Mal vorgezeigt, da machen wir was mit diesen Ringen.
Oder? We still had the feeling to train in a team and it helped a lot to do some trainings that you don't really like to do, like hangboarding and stretching.
Ja, servus, ich sitze gerade daheim da in Innsbruck in meinem Garten.
Mir hilft es, dass ich mir irgendwelche kleinen Ziele setze. Ich habe noch nie einen Handstand geschafft, vielleicht probiere ich das einmal lernen.
27!
I don't think there has been a period in my life since I'm climbing where I didn't climb for that long of a time. Yeah, I definitely miss it a lot. I mean, it's the thing that I love to do the most.
I'm not really someone that is psyched to do a lot of hangboarding and stretching, all these things. It became clear that we had to train in quarantine for a while. So I started ordering wood and built my own campus board, and that improved my training a lot, I would say, especially the motivation. Campusing comes closer to climbing, so it helped me to train some more, I would say.
So, ja, heute ist ganz ein besonderer Tag, und zwar brauche ich heute das Crashpad da nicht fürs Campusboard, weil heute ist der erste Tag, wo wir wieder raus dürfen, und ich mache mir jetzt danach gleich auf dem Weg ins Zillertal, und ja, ich kann es auch gar nicht sagen, wie es mir taugt. Ich werde mir jetzt aufmachen. Hauen wir das jetzt da rein und dann geht's los.
Before the quarantine and during the quarantine I did more like power or like maximum power training, so I was more psyched to start with some bouldering, and there were two boulders in my mind that I really wanted to do in the Traumschiff. In Zillertal, first it was Nihilist sit. It's a sit start to a long standing 8A, 8A plus stand start, which makes it about AP plus, and it's this really nice roof with all these amazing crimps that I only heard of and never seen before. Then there was this other boulder down in the Traumschiff, just close to the river, which I've been trying like a few years ago already. It's called Traumschiff, and it was first ascended by Martin Hammerer quite a long time ago, actually. And this boulder was quite weird for me at first. It took me like two or three sessions to finally find a good beta for me. Thank you. actually on the same day where I sent Traumschiff, I went up to Jochberg. It had this long-standing project, which is like a diagonal through the whole wall. And I always wanted to try this one. I actually already tried like a shorter version of it, which has been climbed by Matthias Schierstl, but I really wanted to climb the whole extension. And I was really psyched to do it on the same day as Traumschiff. Quite special about it is that it's long and it has more power endurance elements than you're used to from the Zillertal. Zillertal is usually always like short bouldery routes. And then you have another boulder problem with like, where you actually like kind of do even one or two moves downwards. And from there, you don't really have any boulder problems anymore, but you climb a kind of pumpy 8B plus with like a rest in between. But especially the last like 8 moves are consistent, and you are not allowed to get too pumped before that. Otherwise, you're not gonna make it.
Yeah, like a few days afterwards, I finally found myself on Schleier Wasserfall again.
A wonderful place, but it also has really good climbing and a lot of hard climbs as well. Weisse Rose is one of the really old-time classics. It's one of the really older routes from Alex Huber. What is a bit special, starts already kind of high up. You have to climb a route to get to this big ledge where you can stand, and there the route actually starts. So it starts in a higher part of the sector, basically. So I checked it out like one and a half years ago, and I really liked it, so I knew I had to come back and send it one day. So I came back this year, 2 days ago, bouldered it up and had one really good try where I fell, basically already sticking the crux move but then slipping. So I knew I had to come back as fast as possible. The first part of the route is not so hard. The first 10 meters, then you have a good rest with a knee bar, and from there it basically starts to get hard. You have 6 kind of pumpy, not really easy, not extremely hard, either moves up to a clip, and then the crux moves start. You have a not so good ledge, okay pinch with really good friction, and a really bad undercling, which is really slippery as well. From this position, you need to get your feet really high, and then the crux move is to slap this really good ledge. And basically, if you get it well and you don't slip, you're gonna send the route. The ascent was really good. It went way quicker than I thought. It really fits my style. I like it a lot, and it was not as hard as I expected it to be. It's mostly about one crux move, and I really like this crux move, so I felt like I can send it quite fast. Today I came back and I was able to send it first go. And yeah, pretty excited about it.
But I think in such weird times, it's also about realizing what's truly important to you and not taking it for granted.